when the vet went to go examine her rear end for constipation, found that she did not have an anus. It's so rare. I mean, no one here has ever seen a case of this, and Annex Cat Rescue in our 25 years have never seen a case of this with any of our foster kittens. So we referred her to a board certified surgeon, someone who is a specialist only in surgeries, and they're the ones who do all the obscure surgeries for, you know, strange congenital defects and things in the city. And so she went to the Central Toronto Veterinary Referral Clinic and has been seeing a specialist surgeon there. And yes, they basically had to go in from the outside and create an opening for her and rebuild that last bit of her intestines and sort of close up some of the tears that had developed inside. And now it's just a matter of getting her through this and getting everything that was backed up inside cleared out. And then once she heals up from her surgery, I think what we really have to see is how she heals up and what kind of control she has over going to the litter box once she's healed, because it is quite possible that she'll never really be able to control it. And that is something that we'll have to obviously find a very special adopter for, because, you know, it just makes it a little bit more challenging to have her in the house. But she is a wonderful, playful, cuddly, sweet little girl. And we know that there's going to be someone out there that doesn't mind having a bit of a special needs cat when she is this lovely and this affectionate. So our main goal is to work with cats living on the street in Toronto. And I think a lot of people aren't aware there are an estimated 100,000 cats or more living on the street in Toronto. They're just really good at hiding. So some of those cats are feral, meaning that they've been born outside and grew up wild, not in someone's home. That's usually because people have let their pet cats outside that aren't spayed or neutered. They impregnate other cats that are lost or abandoned. And those kittens grow up wild on the street. The other types of cats that you have outside, a lot of people think it's okay if they're moving or if they're evicted to just put their cats outside. It is a huge problem. We beg of people, take them to a shelter, give them a chance. I don't know where this idea has come from that cats are going to survive okay outside on the street, but it is not a good life. So we work with those cats as well. The ones that are truly feral, if they're living in colonies, we'll help get them vetted, spayed or neutered, so that they're not producing more kittens, vaccinated against rabies, and then returned usually to their community with a tip taken off of their left ear. And that little triangle clipped off the top of their ear tells anyone else in the community that they have already been vaccinated against rabies and spayed or neutered. So it tells animal services not to come pick them up. It tells the community that someone is already looked after vet care for them. If there's kittens and they're young enough, we will definitely get them and bring them inside, and they'll go into a foster home to be socialized so that they can be adopted out and live their life as an indoor cat and not living that tough life on the street. And when they've been abandoned, usually they have some trust issues. They're a bit traumatized by what they've gone through, but we'll put them in a foster home to help, again, rehabilitate them, help teach them how to trust again, and again, get them vet care. These cats generally have really, really terrible mouths, need quite a lot of dental care, and a lot of other conditions. Often they show signs of being in a lot of territorial fights. Some of them have been hit by cars, show broken bones and things from that. So there's a lot of vet care for these guys. So some of them stay outside, some of them are brought inside and go into volunteer foster homes, and then we adopt them out.